It is. We talk about it and the Virginia game. And if you look at this one, block punt on the first series that led to a one-play touchdown, that's 7 points. Then Sam throws a flare for an interception for a touchdown, that's 14 points. And then they take it the length of the field in a minute 24 right before the half, that's 21 points. And then we miss a field goal. And then we go for fourth and one on the goal line and we don't make it. So there's just time after time after time we kicked ourselves in the face. And at the same time, I can show them where we're down 31-7 and had a legitimate chance to win the game at the end. So there's so many positives and concerns in that game that it's an easy game to sell people on, especially on the road. You got to take care of the ball and you got to win in the kicking game. And we've shown them some of that stuff this week just to let them understand that Florida State's very talented and they're getting better every day, but we got to worry about us. We lost the Virginia Tech game and we lost the Georgia Tech game with turnovers. And we didn't last week. We protected the ball, even though we had some sacks and we had some negative tackles for loss. But if we'll just take care of our business, protect the ball, we're punting well, we can get field position, we're playing better on defense. So we're trying to learn, Greg, how to win. And that sounds foolish after 2.5 years, but we're trying to show them here's exactly what happens when you win. And if you lose, there's a lot of similarities in losses. And most games, again, are lost. Now, somebody forced those turnovers. Somebody, you know, we stood there, absolutely stood there and let them run and block the punt untouched. So we just had a mental mistake. And you cannot do those things and win ball games against good athletes. I've got to be careful because my assistant coach background's on offense. And I get mad and frustrated if we're not just running up and down the field. And that's unfair. And I got it. I mean, I'm worse than any fan. And I'm harder on our coaches than any fan. And here they are. They score 31 points. They rush for 130, 40 yards. They throw for 1,000. And I'm mad. And I told the players, it's all about winning. If we play awful and win, I'm good. I have learned that. And I enjoyed beating Duke. And I thought it was a fun weekend and a great game. But we got to fix a lot of things. And that's what I tell them, Greg. We're good. We want to be great. And you can't be great and have that many sacks and that many tackles for loss. You can't be great unless you can put great games back-to-back together. And like defensively, it'll still in question. Will they, being bragged on all week, will they play well on Saturday? And I told them, that's just part of this journey. And that's part of the life as a college football player. And it's not you. I mean, look at Georgia Tech playing with so much emotion against us. And then Pitt jumps all over them the next week. This is a hard game to play. And that's why it prepares them so much for life. And that sounds like cliches, but it's really true. Is you have to play every day in practice to prepare yourself to play every game. And you can't turn it on and turn it off. And we're still in that position where we've turned it on and turned it off some. And that's why we're inconsistent. And we can't do that. And everybody says, well, why aren't you winning more on the road? When we get more consistent, we'll win more on the road. Because everything's amplified on the road. Crowd makes it tougher. Travel makes it tougher. I've always felt like you don't get as many calls on the road. I've always felt like there's more turnovers on the road. So you just have to play better. And that's just a huge part of this.